Hammond made me realise how strong air can be, and it's given me, well, a brilliant idea. Maybe you could use air instead of petrol to power cars.
Today, at our top secret lab rat test zone, we're going to see if we can power a car by wind alone. Unfortunately for this lab rat, the only car available for this experiment is his pride and joy, a 1992 Ford Fiesta. He absolutely loves that car. Not sure why, because it doesn't work. So we're going to make a few, how should I put this? Modifications. Now, I wouldn't do this to your dad's car, but it's only a lab rat, he won't mind. With the roof off, we need an expert.
Hello, I'm a kite surfing expert.
Our expert sets to work attaching his high-performance kite to the car. A large kite this size can speed a kiteboard to over 40 miles an hour. But a kiteboard is light and highly manoeuvrable. Can a kite pull a one-ton car? A kite works because things like to move into areas of low pressure. The theory goes that when air flows past a kite, it produces low pressure above the kite and high pressure below it. The high pressure pushes the kite towards the low pressure, lifting it up. The power of the wind also pushes the kite forwards. So by putting the kite at the correct angle, our lab rats should be able to make it pull them and their car along. This is now a grudge match, as that lab rat has found a child's bike from somewhere and wants revenge in the form of a race against the wind-powered car. It's a battle of the eco-energies, as wind power takes on man's muscle.
OK, let's check you were paying attention there. Red team, for an extra point, which do you think is going to win the race? The bike or the wind-powered car? Have a think about it. Yellow team, the same question to you. There's an extra point at stake here, which is needed right now. Which is going to win, bike or wind-powered car?
You need a window.
Okay, I want an answer from you. Made up your answers? Made up your minds?
We say bike.
Why?
Because the wind, the car is too heavy to be pulled by.
And you need a law of wind. But
the bike is being powered by a lab rat, and they're a bit stupid.
Yeah, but at least he knows how to ride a bike.
You reckon a lab rat stands a better chance than. Okay, fine.
We're not.
Yellows?
Car.
You think the car's going to win? So, bike, car. Why?
Because we thought it was going to be the bike, but the car is like...
You like, wouldn't have shown it to us if it didn't have a reason.
Oh, so you're introducing us to the science. We're Blast Lab, we've no idea. So you think the car, you think the bike. Audience, what do we reckon? What do we reckon? Car or bike? Car or bike? What do you think down there?
Bike.
Bike? What do we think down here?
Bike.
Car.
Car.
So you disagree. Why do you think the bike?
Because the car's too heavy.
Well, cars don't generally have sails, do they? Maybe there must be a reason. What do you think?
I think car will definitely win. Do you know why? Because the wind can get a very strong thing on car. Like if you're sitting on a skateboard or something and then kite, it'll get you over probably about 60. So
well, people do that. Yeah, people do that, don't they, with the kite and the skate. Yeah, that's a point. One more answer. Go on.
I think bike, because there's no way that a kite could pull a car.
There is a lot of weight in the car, isn't there? Well, there's only one way to find out. That is to watch it. Let's have a look.
The kite car is moving, but it's slow off the mark and the bike has sped into the lead. With the wind behind them, the car is gaining ground. They're neck and neck at the halfway point and our lab rat can't keep up the pace. The kite car is breezing to victory. Take them back to the plan. Me and my mama hopped in that U-Haul van. I ain't talk to them. Plus, I ain't had no phone in my apartment. Oh, man. Oh, man.
Yeah! Well, there you go. I'm sorry, Reds, you're back to fall of yellows. That's an extra point to you. Well done. Yellow team ahead. Well done, Reds. I'm sorry. You're back to loser. Well, you're back to lab rat. What did you expect? Right, time for us all to move on, and that means both teams must now leave. You've got to go and get changed, ready for the messy, messy mess test. You need your protective suits on. And while they're doing that, I'd just like to watch a little bit of that tape again. I want to see the bit where the lab rat's on the bicycle. This bit. Look at it. Look at that pathetic spectacle. It's pitiful. He let Blast Lab down. He let the red team down, as it turned out.